Hey everyone, my name is Marshall Mine, bringing you a brand new video, and this is going to be a season run using one of my favorite fighters to use in EA Sports UFC, Francis Limitless Carmont. Now, Francis Carmont is a very, very difficult fighter to use, especially in the light heavyweight division, because you'll be going up against far more superior fighters like John Jones, Anderson Silva, Chris Weidman, Alexander Gustafsson. You'll be going up against Jacare, and God help you if you get put in a submission with a player using Jacare. But in this first fight, I am going up against Chris, the All-American Weidman, who is a beast in this game. He has a lot of power in his hands. He's fast and he has beautiful wrestling. So in this season run, while using Francis Carmont, what you will notice is that I am picking my shots a lot. And then all of a sudden, I explode with a barrage of hooks, a flurry. But for the meantime, right now, I'm keeping my distance. I'm not really trying to pressure this guy. I know the kind of power that Chris Weidman has in his hands, and I am being very careful. I do not want to get rocked. I don't want to get dropped. I don't want to get hurt. And I am throwing mostly 1-2 combinations with a few leg kicks in between. I back up, let him throw a strike, miss, and then I immediately come in with a 1-2 combination. He gets me in the clinch, I escape, and right there, like I said, I'm keeping my distance using those 1-2 combinations. And that is the one thing that I've been noticing in EA Sports UFC: if you keep it very simple and if you're patient and just pick your shots like that, eventually you will rock your opponent. Now, the striking in EA Sports UFC needs a lot of work. A lot of people are still able to just walk you down and just wing hooks after hook after hook after hook. And the only strike that actually has enough stopping power to stop those hooks are the leg kicks, like I've said in a lot of videos. But there are a few things in the game that does work. That is fighting technically. You can fight technically, not as effectively as you should be able to, but it is possible. As I am backing up a little bit, and if you look at the way that I am backing up, I'm not exactly running from him, I'm counter striking. A lot of people think that counter punching is about constant sidestepping after sidestepping, sidestep, 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 but that's not what counter punching is. Counter punching is keeping your distance, finding the correct range to throw a strike after your opponent misses. That's what counter-striking pretty much is. And that's what I've been doing to Chris Weidman. I'm keeping my distance. I'm not running from him. I'm not constantly sidestepping. And when I hurt him, I immediately switch to pressuring. Whenever I feel my controller rumble, I immediately start pressuring, force him back, and try to finish him. Right there, I land a massive head kick. He returns with a head kick of his own. A little flurry at the end there, and round number one is over. We go to round number two. Show of respect, we touch gloves. I don't know, I can't freaking talk. I can't freaking talk for some reason right now, so bear with me. I hit it with an uppercut. Like I said, still trying to counter strike, using those 1-2 combinations, and I am landing those 1-2s effectively. Like, back up, boom, boom, boom. Back up, one, two, and slowly, slowly damaging his head. Look at that. It's like everything I'm throwing is landing. And right now, look at the strikes landed, 16 to his 7. Right there, I can tell that he's getting hurt, so I'm starting to turn it up a little bit. He takes me down. Of course, I knew it was only a matter of time before he dumped me. With Chris Weidman, kick him off, get up, back to my counter striking. I don't want to let this guy recover, and I also don't want to get rocked by Chris Weidman, because Chris Weidman is nasty on the feet. He has a lot of power. Trying to defend takedowns, trying not to get rocked. He's throwing those bombs. I'm also watching my stamina. There's so much to pay attention to when you're using Francis Carmont, but his striking is lethal. He has a lot of power in his hands when he lands. If Francis hits you cleanly, you will feel it. Boom, land a massive head kick after catching a kick of my own. I'm still trying to land those 1-2s. I'm slowly but surely landing them. right there, jab, left hook, miss with a head kick, hook, he's swinging wildly. This is like a war right here. Move back, find my distance, put those 1-2s together. Now his sidestepping, he can tell that he's in danger. Right now I'm starting to switch it up. Now I'm pressuring, he can feel it. He feels that pressure. And the fight is about to be over right there. I knock Chris Weidman clean out with pure technical striking, ladies and gentlemen. That was brilliant. I am proud of that win. Moving on to the next fight. In this fight right here, I am going up against John Bones Jones. There is no surprise there. When you're fighting in the light heavyweight division, you are bound to run into John Jones at least three times in your season run. And this is a typical John Jones user. He's throwing all these strikes constantly over and over again. Spinning kicks, massive hooks, just winging them, just going at it. The normal John Jones user. And when what they're doing does not work, they start sidestepping. It's what they always do. So going up against John Jones when using a low-rated fighter like Francis Carmont, the key is patience. You have to be very, very, very patient. You cannot give your opponent a lot of openings to land shots. You have to hold block, use movement, sidestep when you have to, counter only when you have to, if possible. Do not be too aggressive. Watch your stamina. Always make sure you have more stamina than your opponent. And once again, be very careful, because when you're going up against John Jones, he is extremely powerful in EA Sports UFC. He's more powerful in the game than he is in real life. In this game, John Jones is pretty much Mike Tyson. He has bombs in his hands for some reason. So you have to be very careful, or you will definitely, without a shred of a doubt, get rocked. So while going up against John Jones right here, I am, you know, I'm watching my stamina, being very technical. He gets me in a clinch. I get him off. He has low stamina. He's sidestepping, trying to get out of danger. I'm chasing him down with those jabs. He's sidestepping, trying to take me down over and over again. And right there, he gets back his stamina like they always do. But that's okay. We are definitely going to get him. And I am slowly chipping away at John Jones, slowly just chipping away, going 1-2. Keeping it very, very simple, like Bruce Lee said, simplicity is the key to brilliance. I am just using 1-2 combos, chasing him down, 1-1, and he's parrying him, parry the shots, using those 1-2 combos very effectively. He's having a lot of trouble keeping his stamina down, but he has no trouble at all parrying his head. So right here, I'm starting to notice that this guy, he's very good at stalling. A lot of John Jones and Henan Barao users, they are very good at stalling. They will shoot power takedowns on you just so that you can stuff it and so that they can recover. They will sidestep. They won't watch their stamina. And as soon as their stamina gets down, they start parrying to their head because they don't want to get finished. So when I notice that this John Jones constantly parried to his head, I will switch it up and start going to the body, because what is the point? What is the point of constantly hitting your opponent in the head if they're going to just keep parrying it? Right there, he catches my head kick, takes me down, but we are in round number two. I am trying to use my 1-2 combinations again, trying to mix in a few leg kicks in there. Pressuring, but not really pressuring. Just picking my shots. 1-1-2. Right there, he has low stamina. I'm going to get him right there. John Jones knocked out cold by Francis Limitless Carmont. Another win that I am very proud of in this season run. Francis Carmont is a beast if you know how to use him. You just have to use him very, very, very carefully. Next fight, I am going up against Vitor Belfort. The Phenom in EA Sports UFC is a beast. He's nasty. He's very fast. He's very explosive. And he has a lot of power. And in the hands of a very good player, Vitor Belfort is a very tough cookie to deal with. Now my opponent is throwing a lot of jabs. I'm starting to notice that he's going jab, 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 and either a kick to my leg or a kick to the body. He keeps doing that over and over again. It's a combination that he's comfortable with, and you have to disrupt their pattern. Whenever you notice a combination that your opponent is very comfortable with, you have to disrupt that combination. Show him that that combination does not work, and that is why usually I would just stand in front of these people. Go ahead, wing all your shots. Do what you gotta do. I'm just gonna block, and then I'm gonna wait for you. When you're done, then I'm gonna come on strong. Right here, I can tell he's getting real tired, and he's rocked right there. He goes for a takedown, goes for a power takedown. I try to submit him, but it's Francis Carmont. His submission is not that great. So submitting Vitor Belfort, the Gracie black belt, is going to be very difficult in this fight. And Vitor is still using those jabs. Jab, 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 going crazy. Using leg kicks, throwing hooks. And Francis Carmont is just looking to get out the way. Use movement. Use those front kicks. And right here, what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to death rock the hell out of him. I'm trying to knock his head off his shoulder. He has me pinned up against the cage. We do not want that, so we're going to slowly circle out the cage. But he's cutting off the cage really well. He's using those leg kicks to keep me in place, which I don't blame him. Do what you got to do. I'm going to do what I got to do. He's using those jabs, jab, 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 trying to back me up. But he's not really watching his stamina. He's not really blocking, and right there he drops me. I get back up. I'm still using my 1-2 combinations effectively. He's landing those leg kicks, and if you do not know, right now in EA Sports UFC, those leg kicks, they score a lot. So whenever I see someone going for constant leg kicks, as he rocks me right there, rocks me again. He rocked me a third time right there. He rocks me one more time. Francis Carmont is extremely hurt. I am trying my best to survive, backing up. My head is red, and I am gonna put on my running shoes right here. Gotta survive. We do not want to get finished. This guy is chasing me down with those jabs. He does not want to let me recover, as he should. He shouldn't let me recover. He's trying to finish, but I am backing up. I'm using good movement. Practically running from him as round number one is over. We survived that round. And in round number two, we are going to get him back for what he did to Limitless in round number one. And those leg kicks that he's throwing, those leg kicks, they're opening up a lot of counter opportunities, and they're making my head a lot very vulnerable to those big massive hooks. But that's okay. That's perfectly fine. We are being technical while pressuring at the same time. I'm watching him. I can see that he's starting to sidestep right now. He's starting to mix it up to my body as well. And look at that. Total strikes landed 7-2. He is landing a lot of strikes, but that's fine too. Because what we are doing is we are waiting for our opportunity to death rock him. I'm looking for that one opening, that one clean opening, that I'm going to land a bomb that's going to put this guy away. He's throwing all these shots. I'm just watching him, being careful, watching my stamina, making sure I do not get rocked again, because in EA Sports UFC, when you get rocked once, you get rocked again. And he is about to get blasted. Watching him. I see what he's doing. And right there, he's rocked and knocked out cold. Francis Carmont destroys the Phenom in dominant fashion after almost getting finished. That was a good performance. Next fight, we are going up against John Jones again. There is no surprise right here. And this John Jones is throwing a lot of hooks, throwing a lot of jabs, throwing those knees to the body. He's going body head, body head, body head, body head, body head. Those combinations are very difficult to deal with. Usually what I just do is I either back up completely or I just strong block. I stand in front of him and I try to strong block all those shots, if I know that he's going to the body mostly, I try to strong block to the body and come back with a solid counter. So John Jones is throwing all these combinations, and whenever I see a John Jones doing that, what I want to do is I want to try to get him into deep waters, because a lot of these guys, they are very dangerous in round number one, maybe in round number two, when they still have full stamina and they don't really have to worry about stamina management. But in round number three, usually these people, they don't know how to fight in deep waters, and it's very easy to drown them. It's one of the reasons why I really wish there were five round fights in ranked, because a lot of these guys, they depend on the fact that the stamina system in EA Sports UFC is completely messed up, and it does not punish them for spamming all these hooks. If there were five round fights, a lot of these people, they will not be able to survive, because I will just drag their ass into round number four and round number five, and I am literally going to drown them. I'm going to fill their lungs with water until they can't take it anymore, and I am going to drown every single one of them. But it's okay. I'm watching John Jones throwing all these shots, and I'm starting to notice that he's parrying his head really effectively. So what do? I switch things up. I start going to the body. That is what you need to do. There is absolutely no reason why you should keep trying to hit a player in the head if he constantly parries his head. It's a waste of time. So switch things up and start going to the body. A lot of people are very, very good at parrying their head, but when it comes to parrying the body, a lot of players in the game, they're not good at that. So I try to use that to my advantage. He's working my body. I'm being real patient with this John Jones, blocking, parrying shots, countering with those knees, working his body, and he is just swinging like a maniac. And look at our stamina. He drops me right there, gets on top. Remember what I told you guys about the power of John Jones? You have to be very careful about the power of John Jones. But look at our stamina. He has been swinging like his life depends on it, and our stamina is pretty much the same exact thing, which in my opinion makes absolutely no sense. He should have less stamina than I do. I should have a lot of stamina, but like I said, that's the way the game is. The game does not reward technical striking. I mean, look at round two. We have pretty much the same exact stamina, which It makes no sense at all. I mean, a guy who's been swinging this much, his stamina and mine should not be the same. Shouldn't even be close at all. But it's okay. We are going to get him. We see exactly what he's doing. We notice that he's starting to parry those shots to the head. So we are going to start going to the body. He's hitting me. He's hitting me a lot because he does not stop throwing. This guy does not quit. He's constantly throwing shots because he knows there is no stamina penalty. He knows there's no significant consequence for winging all those hooks. There is none. You know, he can just keep going and going and going and going, and right there we're chasing him down with body shots, and we finish John Bones Jones with body shots. Nasty body combination.
Henry, you're a body spammer.
Whatever. That was a good performance. Francis Carmont does it again. Moving on to the next fight. We are going up against Alexander the Mauler Gustafsson. Now, Gustafsson is a nasty, nasty, scary individual in EA Sports UFC. You have to watch out for Gustafsson's right hook. His right hook in this game is a nuclear weapon. It is nasty. He will rock you. He will rock you like there is no tomorrow if you let him land that right hand. So I'm being careful. I noticed that my opponent is not throwing a lot of right hooks. He's mostly throwing jab straight, jab straight, jab straight. That's what he's throwing. And those can really disrupt your combinations. And then as soon as his stamina gets low, he just backs up without holding block, and he just moves out the way with ease, and all those punches miss. He's going for Superman punches, which is also very dangerous with a guy like Gustafsson. And if you will notice in this fight, I am not as patient as I was in my other fights, and the reason for that is usually when I'm doing a season run, I could start off very patient, you know, very technical, watching my stamina, being very careful. But then as the fights go along, I kind of, I guess, start getting a little bored and start, let's just say I stop being technical. I start getting tired of playing, my fingers start hurting, and I kind of start being a little bit careless. So in this fight, I wasn't as technical as I was in my other fights. I am winging hooks with this guy because I just wanted to finish him. I wanted to get him out of there real quickly. So we are swinging. It's pretty much a brawl right now. I'm not really pressuring him that much. I'm trying to be careful to not get rocked by Gustafsson, trying to watch out for those Superman punches, which are very dangerous. And right there, he rocks me, goes for a Superman punch, goes for a massive right hand, goes for another Superman punch. He is going nuts. He is hitting me from all angles. I think he goes for a Superman punch again right there. And he is just hitting me left and right. And it's so difficult to catch up to him because Gustafsson is so tall in this game. He's like 6'5". Right there, I have him up against the cage, backing him up a little bit. He is winging those hooks. He is landing too. Trying to see if I can get him. Can I get Gustafsson? Can I get him? And I get him. He is knocked out cold. You do not mess with Francis Carmont, the beast, Limitless Carmont. That was an awesome finish as well. And if you notice right there, it says 5 wins, 1 loss. I did lose one fight by a long, boring, drawn-out decision to a John Jones that I did not want to post. It was a complete, utter bullcrap fight and horribly boring, so there was no point posting that one. I just wanted to post exciting fights. I am going up against Chris Weidman. And I think this Chris Weidman was a subscriber. I'm not sure if it's this one, but I noticed that he's not really watching his stamina that much. I noticed that he's trying to parry his head. Whenever I see someone trying to parry like that, th there's a very high possibility that he's gonna get brutally rocked when he's trying to parry like that. So I'm being a little bit patient. I'm being very careful when going up against Chris Weidman because I know that Chris Weidman has a crap load of power. Look at that. His stamina is almost completely low. He's using good movement, regain all his stamina back because the game allows him to do that. I don't blame him. Backing him up using 1-2 combinations. Right there, he's rocked. He goes for a takedown. Can he survive? Can he survive? He's rocked again. Good head movement, man. Awesome head movement. He goes for a power takedown. Very smart. He's stalling, so we have to back up and let him get up because we don't want him to recover too much. Back to pressuring. We're backing him up again. Now I know this fight is mine. I know he's hurt. I know he's felt the power of Francis Carmont. He knows what it feels like to get hit by Francis now. He wants no part of Carmont. He wants no part of it. He's backing up. He feels the pressure. He feels it. The pressure is too much for him to deal with. Look at that. He's trying to parry his head. And Francis is just watching him. Watching him. Asking him to open up. Give me that opening. Stop parrying. Stop trying to clinch up with me. Let me go. He goes for a takedown. Francis defends a takedown. He's chipping away at him. 1-2. Backing him up. Back up, Chris Weidman. Back up when you have Francis Carmont in front of you. Back up. You have no chance, Chris Weidman. He goes for a takedown and takes me down. But Francis wants no part of the ground game when Chris Weidman is on top, so he kicks him off. Can Francis do it? Can he rock Chris Weidman again? Can he do it? Can he rock him again? We are going to find out very soon. Uh-oh, he's rocked again. Can Chris Weidman survive? Can he survive? Can he survive? No, he gets knocked out cold by Francis Limitless Carmont. Another impressive finish by Limitless. Awesome performance. And right there, we are two fights away to getting the belt. Right now, we are going up against Tim Kennedy, the soldier, or the ex-soldier. The guy that got completely obliterated by Yoel. What's that guy's last name? Yamero or something like that? I'm not sure. But this guy is pressuring me a little bit. He's standing in front of me, which tells me that he has a plan. He has a plan. He's not backing up. Either he wants to take me to the ground, or he wants to clinch, or he has a nasty combination that he wants to unload on me as soon as I open up. So I'm not opening up. I'm standing in front of him, being extremely technical, and right there I see what he wants to do. He wants to hit me with elbows. He wants to hit me with all those elbows. For some reason, in this game, Tim Kennedy has a crap load of power. He will rock you, so you have to be very careful. And right there, he's trying to throw front kicks, but I'm interrupting those strikes with jabs. That's exactly how I wish every single strike in the game was. The strikes that should have stopping power should be stopping you in your tracks. Look at that. He's parrying like crazy. Parry, 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 parry. I gotta parry these shots. I'm like, you stand in front of me and you're trying to parry. He got that one. I parried ahead. He's not watching his stamina. While he's trying to parry, his stamina is going down, but he backs up and regains all his stamina, and he's unloading hooks. But that's okay. We'll stand right there and we'll watch him. He's rocked. Drop him. I don't have any stamina to finish him with. I think I get back to my feet right here. I'm not sure. Maybe I did, because I realized there was no point. Either I got back to my feet or he escaped. Let's see. What did I do? Yeah, he escaped. He managed to get up. I see that his head is hurt. And right here, I'm going to let my hooks go and see what Tim Kennedy has to offer. Right there, he goes for a takedown. Francis Carmont defends it. Can he finish him? Hook, 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 hook. Boom. Tim Kennedy is knocked out cold. Like I said, in this game right now, what I do is technical, 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 and then I explode. I explode with a flurry of punches, and that usually does it. Ladies and gentlemen, we have arrived at the last fight of the season against a monster in EA Sports UFC, Alexander the Mauler Gustafsson. Now, this guy that I was fighting, I would say that he was, at first, he was trying to use Gustafsson in a very intelligent way. He's backing up. He's trying to land massive shots that are going to rock me. He's landing those spinning elbows to the head. And I think he actually did rock me with a spinning elbow in this fight. And whenever you see those spinning elbows coming from the likes of Gustafsson and John Jones, you have to be very careful. And when I get close, he tries to take me down. And he's throwing some nasty, nasty shots. Spinning elbows, Superman punches, more spinning elbows, spin kicks to the body. Everything he's throwing is full power. He is literally trying to knock my head off. And right there, he has no stamina. Try to chase him down, but Gustafsson is far too tall. He's way too tall. Right there, he drops me with a spinning elbow. That thing has a lot of power. A lot of power to it, and he keeps going for it. He's going for head kicks. He's going for bombs. Look at that. He's going for a spinning kick. One more spinning elbow, and he is rocked right there. He gets a power takedown with absolutely no stamina. How he did that, I have no clue at all. But Francis Carmont is not fazed, though. Francis Carmont understands. He knows. He knows that he has a lot of power in his hands. He knows it's not going to take much. He knows that he just needs to rock Gustafsson one more time, and he is going to knock him out cold, as he does right there. And ladies and gentlemen, that is the season run with Francis Limitless Carmont. This guy is a hidden gem. He's a beast. He has a lot of power in his hands. Like I said, if you're going to use Francis Carmont, you have to use him in a very intelligent way or you will get knocked out cold. So try Francis Carmont. Try to get good with him. He is very fun to use. And I hope you guys enjoyed this season run. I try to stay away from the ground game to create a more exciting video because I know you guys prefer striking. But leave a like if you enjoyed the video. Leave a comment. Let me know what you thought about this. And I will see you guys in the next season run. Be safe, guys. Thank you for watching.